Focus. Yes. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel, to my full month of nothing new. I am very excited about today's video. We are back up in my bathroom because I'm going to be sharing with you guys an updated version of my skincare routine. See this little corner? That little bin holds all of my current skincare products that I use, both AM and PM, so we're gonna go through it today. I do get a lot of questions from you guys. What I do for skincare, have I had anything done when it comes to skincare? So we're gonna be answering all of that today. I am a big believer in basic skincare. You don't need to spend a lot of money to take good care of your skin. As you will see with most of the products that I use, I am 40 years old officially as of a few weeks ago. I've never had Botox, I've never had fillers, and while I'm not opposed to either of those things, for right now, in the time being, I like to stick with things the natural way. So this is what I do to take care of my more maturing skin. This is what I swear by, this is what works for me. I am by no means an expert. These are just the things I have found over the years to work well for my skin, and most of them are affordable. So I'm excited to share them with you guys. I hope that you guys are looking forward to it. Before we get into it, I want to give a special welcome to any new visitors to my channel. I hope that you are enjoying my full month of nothing new. I hope that you'll consider subscribing before you leave. And with all of that said, let's hop over to my corner. I'll give you guys a little tour. So here's my bin. This sits next to my sink on my countertop in my bathroom. And pretty much everything that I use skincare related is in here. So I'm gonna walk you guys through everything that's kind of in my routine and kind of when I put it in my routine. But I want to start with something that's not actually up here, and it is my facial wash. So I actually just use a bar face wash. This is just from Cetaphil. It's their sensitive skin facial bar. I've been using this on and off for about 15 years now. I've gone back and forth and tried some other things, both high-end and affordable, and that just seems to work well for me. I'm not too picky when it comes to cleansing my skin, and that's nice and gentle. It removes everything without stripping my skin or making it feel too dry, and it just gets the job done, no frills. And I generally use that both AM and PM. Sometimes in the morning, if I've thoroughly washed before bedtime, I'll use the Cetaphil cream cleanser. Most of the time, I just use that facial bar. So let's go through my AM skincare routine. So the first thing I do in the morning after I wash my face is apply either a vitamin C treatment or a spot treatment. So I have been using this recently. So this right here is from, there we go, main focus. So this right here is a online prescription. It's called Muesli. This is a spot cream. It's made of hydroquinone. I think this one is, I think it says 12%. Also has kojic acid, niacinamide, hydrocortisone in it. I've had this for about 4 or 5 months now. I noticed pretty significant results the first couple of months that I used it. Then summer hit, and really for this, I think, to work, you really need to be staying out of the sun, which I tried very hard to do, but vacations happen, baseball games happen. I've had a hard time staying out of the sun. I've noticed some of the dark spots starting to come back. So I've actually given this a little bit of a rest more recently and kind of just been going rather than that. So initially I would use this morning and night when I first got it, but I've actually been taking a break from that recently, and in the morning I have been going in with this. This is just a vitamin C. I actually got this one on Yes Style. This is a radiance boosting C capsule serum. Honestly, I don't even know the percentages or anything because the writing on the back is not in English, so I can't remember what the percentage of vitamin C or even what the source of vitamin C is on this one, but I did get really good reviews, and I've been using this for a couple of weeks now, and I really do like it. I'm not sure how much it's doing for my skin, but I think I'm gonna use this until the end of the summer and another couple weeks, and I might go back to the Muesli product and start using this one again, maybe in September. I actually have a backup waiting for me. This one's just about gone. Then after I finish that one, they also make a spot cream that has some tretinoin in it, which is Retin-A, another name for Retin-A. So I might try that one this fall or maybe more winter time. We'll see how that goes. I told myself when I turned 40 I would start Retin-A or tretinoin, so that is the plan. After that, I usually like to wait for that to sink in for a couple of minutes, at least 2 or 3 minutes, and then I will take a little bit of a hyaluronic acid. I have this one right here from Flower Beauty. I just finished one from The Ordinary. I have another of those on backup, but I'm using this in the time being. I find it works just fine. So I will take this, I will add a drop of water to this, apply it all over my face, and then immediately after that, I'll go in with my moisturizer. So this is my favorite moisturizer. Right now, I used to use the Cetaphil Daily Moisturizer, the big bottle with the green lid, if you're familiar with that one, but I like this one a lot better. It does also have some added benefits in it. It has ceramides and hyaluronic acid. It's nice and lightweight. Initially, I wasn't sure it would be hydrating enough, but I find it, especially combined with a little bit of extra hyaluronic acid, it does a really, really good job of keeping my skin moisturized and hydrated all day long. So I love this one. This is just a mini size. I'm actually almost out. I need to go buy a full size of this one. I do like it a lot better than the Cetaphil. So after that moisturizer has sunk in a little bit, I usually like to go in with a tiny amount of a really nice oil. So I have two here. Let's start with this one actually. So this one I just am finishing up. This is just a organic rosehip seed oil. I got this one on Amazon. I like this one a lot. I do think that I've found now that this one can be a little bit heavier. It doesn't go on quite as lightweight. So what I've been using instead of this one and really enjoying is this one right here. So this is also from the brand The Ordinary. This is their 100% plant-derived squalane. This is a really nice oil. If you have dry skin, but you want something that's not going to be too heavy, this is a really thin, lightweight oil. I use just the tiniest drop of this. I put it onto my skin after I've moisturized. I feel like it kind of locks in my moisturizer. It also makes my skin really nice and soft for when I go in later with my foundation. Really nice oil, very affordable. It's getting pretty close to running out. I will definitely be replacing this one when it is gone. And one added note, I do often use this at night as like a last step, and I love this on my neck and the back of my hands. Last thing for the daytime is a good sunscreen. I love this one. This is from Coppertone. This is the Defend and Care Face Sunscreen. I like Coppertone sunscreens. They're often zinc based. I've mentioned a few times that I do like a sunscreen that has zinc oxide in it. I find they work a little bit better on me and are not quite as greasy feeling. They don't give me that shiny, greasy effect. They do go on with like a white cast, which is initially a little bit scary looking, but if you give it enough time to sink in, that white cast will go away. So I'll usually put this on up here after all of my moisturizers and oils have sunk in and let this sit for a while before I go in with my foundation or even with a primer. And that's pretty much it for my morning routine. So I want to go through a couple of things that I do like to use often at night or rotate in at night. There's a lot more rotating that happens in my nighttime routine. So after removing all my makeup with my bar soap, I occasionally like to go in with this. I will try and use this about once or twice, probably about twice a week. This is from The Ordinary. It's their glycolic acid 7% toning solution. I can't remember who recommended this as a good AHA or BHA. Honestly, guys, I'm not great on skincare like terminology, so don't quote me on this, but I did hear someone recommend this as a good exfoliant, so I try and use this every couple of days, especially since I've been using the muesli, because I don't tend to rotate in my AHA or BHA treatments at night when I'm using this one, so I'll use this toning solution before I go in with my spot cream. This is pretty affordable. It's from The Ordinary. I just put it on a cotton ball and apply it all over my face and just let it sit for a couple of minutes. Then typically I will go in with a good moisturizer or a good treatment. I actually just finished one of my night treatments that I really enjoyed. Rather than run and grab, I'm saving that one for an upcoming empties video. It's going to be coming up very soon, but it's a really nice night repair serum from Misha. I got it on YesStyle. I'll link it for you guys down below. That's a really nice hydrating one that I will often just top with a basic moisturizer like my CeraVe. But depending on the night, I also like to rotate in some other AHA or BHA solutions. So a couple ones that I really love. First off, this one right here. This is from Pharmacy. This is their Honeymoon Glow. This one is pretty strong. This is my second bottle of this one. I've been using this one on and off for a couple of years now, and I do really like this one. It is pretty strong. I usually will only use this one like once a week, but it does a really good job of like really resurfacing, I guess. I mean, I notice a difference in the morning. My skin looks a lot more like it has this like red flush to it. I can't explain, but in a good way. Looks a little bit more radiant and youthful. Can be pretty strong though, so if you have very sensitive skin, you might have issues with this, because sometimes this one can burn even my skin, which is not sensitive. I also really like this one. This is a toning solution. It's kind of a peeling solution. This is the AHA 30%, BHA 2%, 10-minute exfoliating facial from The Ordinary. This is one that I don't leave on. You're only supposed to leave it on for about 10 minutes, which is typically what I do. So after I wash my face, I'll apply this like once a week and let it just sit for 10 minutes, and then you're supposed to rinse it off. And once you rinse it off, you can go in with a really nice moisturizing treatment or just a basic moisturizer or moisturizer and an oil, which is what I will often do. Works really well. It is quite strong. I would recommend being very cautious in using this, but it does work good for me. I never use it in combination with any other AHA or BHA, including my toning solution. I won't use these two together. I'll kind of pick one or the other, but this is one that I like to work into my rotation on occasion. And then one more from The Ordinary. This is a very gentle exfoliant. This is the Ordinary Grand Active Retinoid 2% Emulsion. This is a really nice one. It has a really nice soft scent. It actually reminds me of a skincare product I used to use when I was a teenager from Origins. I don't remember what it was, but this smells exactly like that product used to smell. It's really nice. It's pretty gentle. This is probably my most gentle of the exfoliants or AHA, BHAs that I use or work into my rotation. And this one you do leave on your skin. So after I apply this one, and actually the same is true with the Pharmacy, I leave both of these on. But after they've sunk in for just a couple of minutes, I'll usually go in with just a basic moisturizer. I'll take my CeraVe, add a healthy amount of this all over my face and my neck. And then often on top of that, I'll put just a drop of the squalane oil in, and that just makes my skin super hydrated, super soft. And I really notice a difference the next morning, especially when I mix in that tiny drop of oil or add that on top. So one thing I do also use at night is my lash serum. I have mentioned this in a couple of favorites videos. This is from the brand Vibe Beauty. I get it on Amazon. Actually, my sister recommended this for me, bought it for me, and I've been buying it a couple of times since. I think this is my third tube now. I notice a big difference with this lash serum. It does make my lashes longer. It doesn't necessarily make them thicker, which I kind of wish that it did, but it definitely makes them very, very long. When I stop using this for a couple of weeks, I notice that my lashes start to kind of diminish, and then when I use it again, it does start making a difference within a couple of weeks. So this one's pretty affordable. I think you can get it for around $28 on Amazon. I will link it for you guys down below in case you're interested in a good affordable lash serum. So that's pretty much it for my basic skincare routine. I also have a bottle here of Aquaphor that I just use on my lips or if I have any dry patches, like eczema type patches or irritation anywhere, like on my elbows or on my heels, I'll sometimes use this, but I mostly just use this on my lips at night. Pretty basic, but it does the job. And that is pretty much it for my skincare routine. Not a ton of stuff. My skincare is pretty basic. I'm a firm believer in sunscreen. Never forget your sunscreen. I mean, double layer your sunscreen, reapply if you can. That in my mind is like the best thing you can do to help slow the aging process. There's no way to stop it completely unless you do more drastic measures like Botox and fillers and stuff, but those are not things that I'm doing right now, so I really rely on my sunscreen to help me out when it comes to slowing down that aging process. But other than that, I think just taking basic good care of your skin, I try to do a good job. I'm not perfect. I have been known on occasion to fall asleep in my makeup, which is a huge no-no, but I do it on occasion. I try not to, but sometimes it happens. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Hopefully it showed you that you don't have to spend a ton of money on skincare. I know there are a lot of people out there that are skincare junkies, and they very well may know what they're doing and certainly know more than I do, but this seems to work really well for me. It works well for my normal to dry skin. And until the day that I decide to do something more drastic, if that ever comes, this is what gets the job done for me. So I hope you guys found that helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please remember to subscribe before you leave, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye. I maybe should start wearing my contacts more, because I noticed the other day, I'm like, why am I so red haired all the time, so dry? And then I remembered the glasses ruining my skin on my nose. But man, I love to see a whole new world, dazzling place I never knew. Thank you.